what Krishna told end of the Gita? He gave that very valuable advice to a very dear friend who needed it most. As you know, Arjuna became emotional. He lost his balance. He couldn't do what he was ought to do. It's to fight a righteous war. And help came timely through a very dear friend, his advice which he gave, the Gita, which you know. At the end of it, having given the advice, you know what Krishna said? According to the 18th chapter, 18 chapters got 78 verses. One of the last messages he gives to Arjuna, having given the entire advice to him. End of it, he said, Yatha Ichchasi Tatha Kuru. Yatha Ichchasi Tatha Kuru. What does it mean? What does it mean? You do what you think is right. What you think is right, please do it, Arjuna. He thereafter did not have any interest in the outcome of his actions. You spend so much time and effort and attention you have given to someone. Having given an advice, what is the least that you would expect, sir? That he follows. So you're giving an advice, like in Shakespeare, Polonius gives an advice to his son Laertes in the play Hamlet. You must read that. You must read that excerpt from the play Hamlet. Polonius is a minister, and Polonius advice to Laertes, his son. Laertes, his son, is going for higher education, and the parting message Polonius gives to his son is one of the most valuable piece of any English literature. It runs into the 15-20 lines. It's outstanding. So when you give an advice, isn't it you expect that the advice is taken? But Krishna, he openly says, I have no saying in the choice you make, whether you still want to fight the battle or you want to abandon it. You decide what you think is right. Now, what does that symbolize? Which is very, very important in our conduct of life, whatever we do. You don't trust. Yeah. You don't trust your ideas having given. What does that convey? What is that quality we all need to imbibe and practice? In fact, we lose the game of life in that particular quality. We have lost it. Because we have that tremendous, terrible attachment, isn't it? To your near and dear, most importantly. You mean so much to do for them, you are interested in the welfare, and it really hurts you when you see them not following or taking that advice or enabling them. So you're trying to enable or ennoble them, but yet you don't, you see them not making use of it. It's one of the most difficult things to accept, especially to near and dear. If you give an advice to your colleague, he doesn't take it, not bothered. No, that's your life, man. How am I interested? You don't see what I'm telling you. That's you. That's. I don't care. But yet you care. You gave advice to him. Yet you have that attitude of I don't care. In that caring. But when it comes to the most important areas of your family, of your kith and kin, of your near and dear, you are not able to play that role. And there you pay the price. Exactly what Arjuna went through. He got caught up in that emotion. So what is that quality Krishna is conveying? He was a witness. If you can practice being a witness to your actions, he was a sakshi. That word witness is sakshi. That sakshi bhava. In English, it's called being objective. You're objectively watching all what's happening, as if you're unconcerned, but you're very much concerned. So you're concerned to your duties, you must be unconcerned to the consequences of your action. A mother teaches a child with great effort. Then after, whether a child passes in merit or doesn't do that well, the mother ought to have an unconcern to the fruits of action, isn't it? Yesterday, Vaishnavi, remember what I was telling? We all were going for dinner yesterday night. And there was a reference in some context. I'll not take a reference of the context. You remember me saying this, Vaishnavi? Ours is just to introduce what is the best to you. It is yours to decide, isn't it? You remember me say, I said that statement to her yesterday. As a parent, my job is to give her the best, whether be it music or education or whatever. I'm not saying she's choosing the right or wrong. It's not my job. If she chooses a particular thing, mine is to only give her that exposure. I can even be instrumental in the choice to make, but I can't be concerned with the choices she makes. Not now, not later. To keep my sanity, I must be objective. But if I start deciding what you should do, I have lost my peace of mind. So those people who should be very near, in fact, the people who are very near and dear to you cause you more pain than your enemies out there. You may have people, you will have people who don't like you, but they're not causing as much trauma to you as much as your near and dear are causing, which is a tragedy of life. It's the saddest thing that can happen in life, is someone who means something to you, you do so much for them, and yet they cause the misery to you. And yet it is not they, it is how you deal with them. You do not know how to deal with them. It is not your near and dear. You seem to blame them. It's not them, it's how you relate. If you have the little dispassion, little detachment, little renounce, just renounce, yeah. Doesn't matter. How does it matter?